I was born whilst my father was actually being demobbed. So he came back, went back for demob, came back, and we lived with my grandma in a back-to-back in Elland. And then when my dad came back, we went to Morley in Leeds and lived in a prefab. And then we managed to get a car and a television and then moved to a semi-detached house. So we were really starting to fly in those days. I had a pal. I was at Peel Street School, and his sister called Pat. I fell in love with at 11. And the only way I could really keep in touch was at the Salvation Army Youth Club, because they were both Salvationists. And I said to my parents, I really think we should go to the Salvation Army instead of the Zion Methodist. And my mum said, look, you can only go if all four of you want to go. And if you all four don't want to go, you have to stay as you go to Sunday school. So I took them along on a Sunday and we had a belting time, and it was just one big happy family and music and singing and enjoying yourself and rejoicing. Kids loved it. So as a team, we went to Morley Salvation Army and I could watch Pat Aveyard every day. My father, as I say, came back from the war, was enthused with catering, and eventually, very quickly, ended up in a transport cafe. So bacon and sausage sandwiches, cooked to order. I can smell it as we speak. I can hear the frying of bacon, because it's real bacon and sausage in those days, not like sadly today, pumped full of water. This was good pork meat, and it was delicious. And you learnt about service, keeping people happy, and I've been in love with food ever since. I applied to the Savoy Hotel, and they said they didn't have a position, but at Simpsons in the Strand, which is part of their empire, they had a position. It was very much a humbler, although busier place, and it was traditional British food. And then from there, I got transferred to the Savoy Grill, and I went to work with a French chef and really stepped up the quality of the cooking that we did. And that's really what I knew then, that's what I really wanted to do. I wanted to do top-class stuff. I have to say that when I came to London, for the first 2 weeks, I was extremely lonely. The family environment at home and the family environment of the Salvation Army had actually mollycoddled me, had got used to it. But I had another guy who'd come down from Leeds with me. We decided to get a flat, and we went to an agency, and they said, yeah, go to this place, it's in Primrose Hill. So we went to Chalk Farm Tube Station, came out, as I walk out, there's Marine Isis, but even more important, Chalk Farm Salvation Army. So we took the flat, moved in there, and I walked into Chalk Farm. And of course, I was instantly enveloped in another family. I loved being at Chalk Farm. I was YPSM for a while. I ran the nightclubs for the nightclubs, youth clubs for the young people, but younger than the youth clubs that I used to go to. They were 7 and 8 year olds, and we used to have a great time playing football in the junior hall. And the bandsmen were a little bit sniffy about someone who had never heard of Chalk Farm, famous Salvation Army band, and they did have a great reputation and they did play extremely well. But as all Salvationists do, they opened their arms and I went to play in the band. I played second horn, second baritone, second cornet. I would have played second triangle if there'd been a triangle player there. And we even toured Europe, and we were the first band to play in the Vatican for the Pope. We played out in St. Peter's Square and we marched in playing. And when the Pope actually mentioned us, we sang Blessed Assurance, and it was just touches the heart. I got the opportunity with a partner in 1986 to open my own restaurant. We opened up in Walton Street, and I just had a great time. You know, the actual feeling of watching people enjoying, saying, oh, that was a great, oh, thank you. It's been a lovely evening. Thank you very much. We'll see you soon. And going away and coming back soon. That, to me, is what the hospitality business is all about.
Let's welcome our culinary kings. They are James Martin and Brian Turner!
Hey there, Jamie. Nice to see you. OK, fantastic. Hello, sir.
Hi. I'm damn fine to see you.
How you doing?
Hi, mate.
Very, very good. Now, what type of music are you into these days, then, Brian?
Really popular brass band stuff.
Yeah? You like the...
I love all that, yeah. Ready, Steady, Cook came about, and my business advisor said, don't do it, it's cheap television, it's entertainment, it's not about real cooking. And I said, I don't agree with that. I think it's an opportunity here. This is entertainment and education. And so we auditioned for it. I did all the major shows, did the first, the 50th, the 100th, and all those kind of shows. My dad came on the show on Ready, Steady, Cook, and it was great. So I did This Morning and Ready, Steady, Cook. I did Ready, Steady, Cook 14 and a half years.
Mr. Brown Turner for services to tourism and to training in the catering industry.
People in the office and my mates who'd been involved in the reference all knew this. I knew nothing about it till the letter. And I was frightened to tell my family for a couple of weeks. I thought, it can't be right. There's something wrong here. But actually, that was just marvellous, marvellous, marvellous. The best thing about the Salvation Army really goes back to my first contact with the Salvation Army. It's family, it's friendly, it's a genuine want for people to respect each other. And if the world were just to look at respecting people, we would not have the tragedy that we have today. And so for me, it's very much this welcoming arms into the family. Doesn't matter what your record was, from when we meet you, that's how we judge you.